स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ वी विल स्टडी फेरोमैग्नेटिक सब्सटेंसेस। फेरोमैग्नेटिक सब्सटेंसेस आर दोज सब्सटेंसेस इन विच ईच इंडिविजुअल एटम और मॉलिक्यूल और आयन हैज ए नॉन जीरो मैग्नेटिक मोमेंट एज इन पैरामैग्नेटिक सब्सटेंसेस। व्हेन सच फेरोमैग्नेटिक सब्सटेंसेस आर placed in an external magnetizing field, they get strongly magnetized in the direction of field. Examples of ferromagnetic substances are iron, cobalt, nickel, gadolinium and their alloys. Now we will study properties of ferromagnetic substances. Ferromagnetic materials show all the properties of paramagnetic substances but to a much greater degree. For example, ferromagnetic substances are strongly magnetized in the direction of external magnetizing field in which they are placed. They have a tendency to move from a region of weak magnetic field to region of strong magnetic field. It means they are strongly attracted to a magnet. Third, relative magnetic permeability of a ferromagnetic material is very large, approximately 10^3 to 10^5. The susceptibility of ferromagnetic substances is also very large because we know that mu r is equal to 1 plus chi m and susceptibility chi m is equal to mu r minus 1. As mu r is 10^3 to 10^5, therefore when we subtract 1 from mu r, we get chi m. Therefore chi m, that is the magnetic susceptibility of ferromagnetic materials, is very large, of the order of 10^3 to 10^5. With the rise in temperature, susceptibility of ferromagnetic substances decrease. At a certain temperature, ferromagnetic materials change over to paramagnetic materials. This transition temperature is called Curie temperature. For example, Curie temperature of iron is about 1000 Kelvin. Now we will study explanation of ferromagnetism. Ferromagnetism has been explained by Weiss on the basis of domain theory in addition to usual electron theory. Like paramagnetic substances, each atom of a ferromagnetic substance is a teeny magnetic dipole having permanent dipole moment. However, in ferromagnetic materials, atoms form a very large number of small effective regions called domains. Each domain has a linear dimension of 1000 angstrom and contains about 10^10 atoms. Within each domain, a special interaction called exchange coupling aligns dipole moments of all the atoms in a particular direction. Thus, each domain is a strong magnet without any external magnetic field. In spite of this, a ferromagnetic substance does not behave as a magnet, because in the absence of external magnetic field, the magnetic moments of different atoms, they are randomly oriented, so that resultant magnetic moment in any direction is zero. Therefore, in the absence of external magnetic field, ferromagnetic substances do not behave as magnet. When an external magnetic field is applied on a ferromagnetic substance, it gets strongly magnetized. This can be understood in terms of displacement of boundaries of the domains. That is, the domains which are in the direction of field, they increase in size. And the domains which are oriented opposite to direction of field, they decrease in size. Therefore, in ferromagnetic substances, a net magnetic moment is produced in the direction of applied magnetic field. Second, rotation of domains. Domains rotate till their magnetic moments are aligned in the direction of magnetic field. This would happen only when the applied magnetic field is very strong. Therefore, in the external magnetic field, these ferromagnetic substances are magnetized in the direction of applied field. When external magnetic field is removed, then some materials lose their magnetization. For example, soft iron. Such materials are called soft ferromagnetics. While the material like alnico, in these materials, magnetization persists even after the removal of external magnetic field. Therefore, such materials are called hard ferromagnetics. With the rise in temperature, the magnetization of the ferromagnetic substances decreases. At a particular temperature, ferromagnetic substances change to paramagnetic substances. Such temperature is called Curie temperature. With the rise in temperature, magnetization of the ferromagnetic substance decreases. At a particular temperature, ferromagnetic substance changes to paramagnetic substance. This is because with the rise in temperature, domain structure disintegrate with the rise in temperature. Therefore, their magnetization decreases. The temperature of transition from ferromagnetism to paramagnetism is called Curie temperature. This Curie temperature for soft iron is about 1000 Kelvin. Therefore, this is the cause of ferromagnetism.